Some of the greatest ever to play the game joined Monica Seles, Mary Pierce and Arantxa Sánchez Vicario and travelled to Singapore for the WTA finals. They took in the views of Marina Bay, then travelled to the famed hotel Raffles to sample one of the island's signature drinks. While a bartender mixed up a couple of Singapore slings, Martina Navratilova and Chris Evert sat down with Open Court to discuss this year's elite players. We began with the world number one.
Angelique Kerber, she's come on strong this year. You know, it's surprising winning two Grand Slams. It's one thing to win one. And Serena's still playing some, you know, really high-level tennis. But I don't remember the last time anybody besides Serena won two Grand Slams. Was that like 10 years ago or
a
something?
A long, long time ago. And not out of nowhere, but did not see her as a number one at the end of the year. And really playing the best tennis, most consistent, and believing in herself so much.
Just playing more, like you said, more aggressive. She has a little more sting on her serve. Yep. She's finally getting that
lefty.
True lefty that I had so much trouble with you.
I know. Used to get upset with herself and lose it for a couple of games or even lose a match because of the mental going off sideways. But now she's just ready to go every point. Some players, when they become number one or the favorites, it's kind of, they put too much pressure on themselves, but she thrives on it. She's backing it up nicely. Simona Halep, amazing mover, but I thought she was mentally tougher like last year, the year before. She's still fighting herself so much. She gets so down on herself. It's one thing to be a perfectionist, like you and I are that. You know, we maybe should have been nicer to ourselves as well, but we didn't let it get in the way of playing our best tennis. And I think Simona gets so upset with one or two shots early in the match, and then she just loses
and
it.
And then the attitude, she's the body language, and it's not. That's my one criticism of her is that it's like I want to tell her, shake her a little bit, and say just be positive out there. But if you remember, Kerber used to be that way too, and she used to give little signs to her player box, and she used to get down on herself,
she
turned it around. Yeah. Hopefully, she'll do it. I mean, she's a great player.
Yeah. The younger generation is now coming together nicely, and I think. We've been hoping that Madison Keys would have a better year maybe last year, but now she's really seems to be picking the spots better when she's going for her shots.
I mean, she's harnessing her power better. She has so much power off both wings, so much easy power. Her serve is comparable to Serena Williams. Yeah. And I think the reason why she's here to stay and she's the real thing is because she's taken baby steps.
Yes.
And she didn't come on really strong like a Jeannie Bouchard or a Muguruza, you know, that one big Grand Slam. She hasn't been ready mentally. And I think the mental and the emotional side is catching up with the physical side. So she has a very good chance next year of winning a Grand Slam, I feel.
Oh, absolutely. That would be a good bet, actually.
I think she definitely has one more, if not two more Grand Slams left in her, especially Wimbledon, where the surface seems to suit her power and her movement. So I would venture a bet that she's going to win one more next
year. If Serena's healthy, it's almost impossible for somebody to beat her on the grass. So that's her best chance at it, but you never know. But I think she'll be motivated. She definitely wants that record. And if anybody can do it, obviously Serena Williams can. The biggest question mark, I think, is her motivation.
Yeah.
But even bigger one would be her health. So if she can stay healthy and get her shoulder organized, you cannot bet against her.
The longtime friendly rivals finished off their visit to Raffles by toasting Martina's 60th birthday.